In the meantime, we need to get our next people on stage. Yeah. And I say people because we promoted with Marco being here. And Marco actually told us, you know, what would be better than one alumnus talking out of his from his experiences? That would be two alumni talking from their experiences. So he's joined by Nick, and together they will talk about surfacization. I will quickly get a chair, which I was meant to do a previous moment, but alas, it is here now. And I'll give this floor to the gentleman.
Thank you. So welcome. Thank you for having us here. We are from CETAC. CETAC is a company. Let's put on this presentation. The button below it. Okay, there it goes. So we're from CETAC. CETAC is a company. We are focused on business intelligence and on improvement of business processes throughout a lot of companies. I am Marco Scheffer. I am a business consultant at CETAC. Nick over here as well is also a business consultant, but we are focusing upon different branches. CETAC, let's start with the company profile. CETAC is a company founded in 1992 with turnover over 80 million for almost last year, a little bit more. 450 employees. And it is stock exchanged, the stock exchange in Amsterdam. We are focusing on a few industries. So manufacturing is one of them. That's why Nick over here is at this presentation, for we are going to talk about surfacization in a minute. And I, on the other hand, I'm focusing on retail and wholesale. But within CETAC, we also focusing on real estate. So if you're interested in that, then that's what we do as well. We have a portfolio on consulting in SAP. So we are addressing customers who want to have SAP or Microsoft as well within their business to improve their business processes. Of course, we do resourcing, but we are focusing upon on projects. We have projects at our customers to improve their business with the use of SAP. And with our business consultancy skills, we can try to give them more business value. And that's what we do. And also, our company is focusing, that's half of it, on hosting and cloud services. But that's not specifically what we are going to talk about today. What I want to start with is that out of trends in the information technology, for instance, the Internet of Things, you all know that, but also machine learning, but those kind of trends in IT are driving us to look at our customers in a way how we can help them focusing on gaining business value out of their business process. And part of our organization is focusing on specifically on innovation and how we can use these trends in IT to go to a customer focus. So we are addressing our customers not by just putting a software within their company for helping them doing their business, but also driving them to go on business value, to create business value. And in that, in the past, this was focused upon a total cost of ownership. So we as a company, of a company is hiring us to buy software and hardware, and after that it's implemented, we are out and they're on their own. So they have to do the maintenance and new software, which has to be implemented on their own or with different companies. And the shift of the total cost of ownership view to a total customer care view is something which the business is focusing upon quite some time right now. So this combined our focus on the business innovations in information technology and how to put it on our customers in the sense of how can we improve their business value is something that what we are going for within our company. So looking for innovations and creating business value at customers. So by having said that, these are two pie charts in what our customers, so as a supplier, for instance, likes to do. In the past, he was looking for selling his machine or his hardware and software, and then got out of the contact with his business partner. But nowadays, they are wanting and thriving for a total cost of the total customer care by going ahead for taking a bigger pie chart and doing things after that. So go for the maintenance as well and becoming a business partner through the whole of the maintenance. So that's thriving is to new business model called servitization, and this is specifically within the manufacturing world, which Nick is going to talk about right now.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, Nick.
So the last one, right? This one?
Yeah, the middle one.
Thank you, Marco. Already said, what we see, especially for our manufacturing customers, is that there's a trend towards servitization. And what actually is servitization? And basically, servitization, means that a customer is not longer actually buying a product, but is buying actually what the result of the product. Very simple example, which is already very old, basically. For example, rental houses. People who live there don't buy the house, but they use the house to live in. So it's basically a very, very early type of servitization. A little bit more recent, of course, rental cars or lease cars. You don't buy the car, but you just drive it and pay for the use of it. There are even more exciting examples of servitization. For example, the engines of an airplane. In most cases, they are not even owned anymore by the air company anymore, but they're still owned by, in this example, Rolls-Royce, who manufactured the engine. And the engine isn't sold anymore, but basically the engine is used and you pay for the hours that the engine is running. So that's a completely different concept. Completely focusing on relieving the customer of any potential issues. So all the customer has to do is use the engines, and that's it, and pay for it, of course. As CTAC, we are an IT company. So when we look at this type of new business models, there's also an IT aspect on that. What do you need to be able to do this? And therefore, we can use actually the new innovations already explained by Marco. Because what do we need? First of all, we need, of course, how the equipment is used. If you say, okay, dear customer, you can use this jet engine for per hour, then you need to know how many hours the engine is running, how it is used. So you need to keep track of the usage. You also need track, of course, to keep track of the status of the engine. Is it still in a good shape? Are there any possible failures that might occur in the meantime? So this information is really important when you want to have a proper way of servitization. And that can be combined, luckily, with the trends that we've seen in IT. So we have sensor technology, small sensors that are capable of sending information. We have cloud technology, which offers space for sharing data. We also have the possibility to create a digital twin, which is actually a digital model of the equipment available for the supplier. And of course, we can also use machine learning, where you have the systems helping you, enabling you to do the right things to prevent any failures, preferably in the future. I want to show you a small movie about a project we did for one of our clients. Let's see if this will work. Where's my mouse?
Bij Palm hebben we een grote passie voor echtheid in traditie. We houden het brouwersambacht in ere. Tegelijkertijd zoeken we telkens naar hoe nieuwe technologie ons kan helpen om onze bieren nog beter te maken. Een voorbeeld is de Estaminet Tapmaster. Dat is ons unieke tapsysteem met een geïntegreerde koeling voor biervaten.
De Tapmaster zorgt dat ons bier continu de juiste temperatuur en druk heeft. De twee belangrijkste elementen voor het tappen van een optimaal biertje. Met onze Tapmaster verspilden we in het verleden soms wel eens bier omwille van een microfiet in de koolzuurleiding of hadden we wel eens een tapprobleem om reden van een te lang openstaande koeldeur.
Daarom hebben we samen met Zetac de Tapmaster Smart gemaakt. Zij hebben de leidingen voorzien van sensoren die voortdurend de druk en temperatuur meten.
Onze Tapmaster houdt nu zelf bij of de temperatuur en druk conform en stabiel zijn. Zo niet, dan krijg ik een seintje via de app op mijn telefoon.
Zetac heeft een informatiedashboard voor ons gebouwd waarin wij zien wanneer bepaalde waarden afwijken. We brengen dan zelf de klant op de hoogte. Meestal kan die het probleem zelf oplossen. Wij hoeven bij gevolg minder vaak ons technisch personeel naar de horecazaken te sturen. Dankzij de Smart Tapmaster behoudt het tapbier van Palm nu ten allen tijde de hoge kwaliteit.
En de optimale werking van de Tapmaster is nu nog meer gegarandeerd. Zo kunnen we altijd nog één rondje geven.
Basically, what you've seen, of course, in this video is, of course, the quality of beer is important, as we all know. But also for Palm, who actually owns the draft beer installation, it's really important that they don't spend too much money on service. So for them, it's really important that a service technician is not going to some silly mistake that might happen. And that's what they prevent by using this technology. And that's what we do basically do at Zetac. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask.
You took the words out of my mouth. If you have any questions, put them in the chat. In the meantime, good to see that you know the student audience a bit. That's also a bit about beer, although I think a lot of alumni still also enjoy a good draft beer every once in a while. We have our first question from Lieke again. Thank you, Lieke, for being so participating. How do you manage the security of your systems? So I presume she means the client's systems in this case.
Yes.
This may be one for you.
No, fine. Mm-hmm. Well, basically, that's also cloud-based, basically. As you might have seen already in the first slide of Marco, we work a lot with SAP technology. And that's integrated in those systems. So we have a centralized, they usually have a centralized cloud-based authorization platform that can be used for that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so basically it's being taken care of by the systems that are in place already. Yeah. Okay, interesting. Then another question from Lieke. Let's see, the timing. Typing was a bit wrong, but when is maintenance needed with such a secure system? If I got the question right.
When is maintenance needed?
You mean the IT system?
I presume the IT system, yeah.
Well, there are regular, you have a number of different items. Eh? You have, of course, technology, which is running forward and forward. So that means there are regular updates anyway, which are pre-described to be able to fulfill also security requirements. And usually, they depending a little bit on the type of platform you're using, the most frequent updates are every quarter, so four times a year. But that's a really cloud-based application. Mm-hmm. Another application is probably once a year, something like that, that you need to do enhancement pack upgrade or a service pack upgrade, just to be able to.
But in itself, it's of course a kind of servitization when talking about cloud computing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So when using SAP software, you can use it on premise, so on your own systems within your company, or using it out of the cloud. And when you use it out of the cloud, SAP as a supplier provides you with all the problems other customers had. They solved it already, and in the next release you get it out of the box for yourself.
Okay.
So it's a kind of servitization in itself.
Yes.
A remark from Chris. I believe a weak link in systems like these are the sensors which can fail. Do you agree?
Yes, I think that's the general remark, which of course is true. I think that's also be applicable to every sensor you have. A mechanical part always has some a moment of failure. Mm-hmm. And that's also what we see in maintenance, that the real mechanical maintenance, that those typical are items that need to be replaced every now and then.
Okay.
And that's of course, but that's still, you still have the advantage, right? If you need to go there to exchange a sensor, that still prevents a number of unnecessary calls.
Yeah. Okay.
Errors, so.
Yeah, but that again is something specifically for manufacturing, where sensors have to be put upon the machines. Mm-hmm. When you look in the industry where I am focusing upon, like retail, the RFID, radio frequency ID, is much more used, and you don't have the need of sensors, for instance.
Okay.
The most of the business we are doing right now with great supermarkets like Jumbo or Albert Heijn. They have already an outlet in the Netherlands where they are working with radio frequency. When you go into their shop, you only have to pick up a cart, mm-hmm. put in your groceries in your cart, take them out again. It is measured by the cart itself. Mm-hmm. And when you go out, you don't have to walk through the cashier, and you don't have to pay.
You will pay, but not.
Yeah, you will pay, but only by walking out of the out of the store, mm-hmm. and it's debited directly out of your account. So those kind of things are working right now as well, and it's also a kind of servitization in that sense.
Okay.
But not with sensors, but with other technology.
Okay. Then a question from Alina. What are the challenges that your clients face what are the challenges you see with your clients when working on implementing the servitization in their company?
There are a number of challenges, basically. First of all, of course, you need to get your business case correct. Mm-hmm. It requires some investment, of course. But it also has some challenges towards the customers of our customers again, because they need to allow data to be exchanged and with their supplier. And that is also a matter of trust. Okay, please, do you trust us that we actually know a lot about your business you are doing? If you know, for example, a pump, or that also gives you information about that company, which might be probably confidential. Mm-hmm. So that also requires a lot of trust to be able to do this.
Okay.
And that's basically then comes back again to change management also to a large extent. Mm-hmm. So in many cases it's more the change management part which is difficult than the technical part.
Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe a bit more of a general question. How has the IT consultancy world changed throughout the years when we look back on it?
COVID helped, but there was already a trend going on in working on different places than specifically at the customer side. In our world, it is more common to work out of the central office of, in our case, CETAC in Den Bosch, for more than one customer. So it's more efficient for us. And that also is based upon trust out of the customer you're working for. Mm-hmm. And that we've built up in, let's say, the last 10 years at least. And now with COVID, we see that our revenue is boosting, it's pumping up. Sorry for that.
No matter.
It's boosting, it's pumping up because we are already capable of working at our office or at home and with all the technology around it.
Okay.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anything to add to that?
I think that that's correct. Especially COVID really boosted that way of working. Mm-hmm. Luckily, we are now together involved in a project for a company in Austria.
In Vienna, yeah.
While we are here in the Netherlands. Mm-hmm. Everything is remote.
Interesting.
Yeah, the whole project started remote. We never met those people in Vienna and in 20 countries all over the world, which are participating as well. And we are the implementing partner. And that also is something about trusting each other and being a trusted advisor. For that's what you have to be. And the shift also has gone to be able as a consultant on putting the customization into the software up to business consultancy. And most alumni which are working with us right now, the young starters, they all have to start as a business consultant. So not at the programmer. We don't have programmers anymore. They're also business consultants with a program capability.
Interesting.
So that's a kind of change in the consultancy world.
Cool. Yeah. Then a question from Yasota. How do you assess the level of sophistication at the manufacturing companies? Do you use a tool? So I presume what they intend is, do you have like a guiding line for that?
No, we don't monitor that ourselves. We look basically per customer. Okay, what are possibilities on this area or are not? We don't have any
striving goals.
No.
So it's really what can be applicable.
What
for
is
this
applicable?
Customer?
Yes, because we don't have we have many different customers basically. So it's very hard to give one single guideline, which is applicable to all our customers.
Yeah,
that's. Just not feasible.
Okay, so it's really a tailor-made look at it. Okay, then I am pretty sure that's all the questions that we had for you today. Thank you again for joining us here. It's been a drive for you. I think you had the longest drive of everyone today.
I think that's me.
You probably had the shortest.
I had the shortest,
think about it. So.